Senor, have you not a single maravedi at the bottom of your purse?
His
would
Majesty's
pay a poor singer better than your forlorn lute.
His Majesty's secret is what the lesson.
Ah, I shall improve by a
course. Have I dreamed?
You have received it with offering?
Yes, Senor. A golden quadruple. He must be a very rich man.
Yes, indeed. Don Rafael D'Arpina, the richest nobleman in Spain. And what song will you sing for me, for the fellow to that golden piece? The one you wore with yesterday? You know, Her Majesty stopped her carriage as she went by.
Ah, yes. Song that is heard at midnight in the ruined palace of the Moorish king.
Thank you.
Your dreams may come to pass.
With her influence over the king, I may approach the neglected queen. Once persuaded of her husband's infidelity, she may be induced to look from her throne for someone to assist in her just revenge. Then, Your Majesty, Don Jose de Santarem will be very much at your service.
Cheats! Cowards! Miserable knaves! Cheating at cards, eh? As if you were noblemen. Robbed. Plundered of my last maravedi. Never mind. Tonight, I shall sip of cool Spanish air and sleep under a blue Spanish canopy.
Don César de Bazán?
Don Jose.
Drake, be seated. You have been a long time absent from Madrid?
Yes, on my travels.
Yes, travel changes a man.
Yes, and his clothes.
Your noble father left you a high name, a brilliant inheritance, and numerous followers.
My inheritance benefits mankind. I still have the name and the numerous followers, my creditors.
And what happy event has restored you to Madrid?
Oh, they told me all my creditors were dead. But my creditors assured me that the reports were much exaggerated. How lives Madrid? Drink and the duels?
Oh, duels are rare since the king's edict.
Edict?
Yes. Those who fight by the sword shall be shot. Except during Holy Week, when the survivor is hanged.
But Holy Week begins today.
Then you had better keep out of trouble.
Hanged? I could never live down the disgrace.
Foolish boy, I would take it to your friend.
Oh, I've got no friend. You should have let me drown myself.
Drown yourself? At your age? Have you creditors too?
No, senor. But my master beat me again today.
Again?
Si, senor. I can no longer endure it. They come to arrest me!
Fear nothing, boy. My sword will defend you.
A sword? In Holy Week? There he is. See that boy?
Arrest him, see the culprit, we arrest him. By my order, this will be.
speaking to you.
Thank you. Thank you.
it is past 5 o'clock.
Oh, 2 hours to go. Why did I wake so early? I had such a lovely dream. I dreamt all my creditors had gone to the moon. How shall I spend 2 hours?
Perdona, senor. You could send for a priest and confess your sins.
Confess my sins? In 2 hours? 2 years. I could make my will, but that would take 2 minutes.
And is there no one, senor, who could beg the king to save your life?
Yes, there is one. Hither as I came, one poor old man with silver hair and teardrops in his eyes wept that my life was wasted to a span, and mercy importuned with bitter cries.
Oh.
any last request?
This boy, can something be done for him?
You owe to him your execution.
I owe something to everybody. Will you take him into your service?
It shall be done. Go, boy, and wait for me with us.
Si, senor. Si, senor.
And do you wish anything for yourself?
No, nothing, thank you.
Then is the last of the Garofas content to be hanged like a dog? Consent to this blindfold marriage. I'll tell her it's the Queen's command.
Senor, senor, for you, senor. And senor, will you permit me not to enter your service until tomorrow?
Why not today?
Don Cesar lives today. Tomorrow, I shall be as devoted to your service as I am to his today.
Noble words. Go tell them to serve us
Spanish wine for a score of men.
Si, senor.
And tell the newly appointed captain of the guards that I wish to see him in the outer chamber at once.
Si, senor.
This paper. A full pardon for Don Cesar. It will not suit the First Minister's plans if this should arrive at the moment. But this is a desperate game I play. And the very thought of possessing the Queen takes me back to the memory of when I first beheld her.
Never seen a nobleman in bridal dress before. Welcome, friend. Fill up and sing.
Attention for the señor alcalde.
Don Cesar de Bazan.
Count de Garapa.
Your sentence has been changed. The king decrees you be not hanged but shot at 7 o'clock. His warden so commands.
One to go. Fill up and sing.
Thank you. My Lady Marchioness subdued a terrific sensibility. Some soldiers would have thought that Holy Week. They should have at their
time. Oh, that's all. What a noise they make. For a mere trifle.
Will the company be good enough to withdraw to the outer room where refreshments await?
Your niece, whom you mislaid 10 years ago.
I have no niece.
Oh, yes, you have. Did I not appoint you a Grand Master of the Royal Menagerie? A terminable post? Now, do you or do you not have a long-lost niece?
Now you remind me, I recollect. I have a niece. Where is Vivian?
Oh, in 10 years of long-lostness. She has grown up.
But where is she? I am all impatient. Is she handsome? Does she resemble me?
Madame la Comtesse de Bazin, may I present your noble uncle, Monsieur le Marquis de Montefiore.
That what Don César de Bazin accepted?
Was to be present at this reception. And here he is.
Ah, it's he.
The Countess.
No, it is not Arthur.
Charming Maritana, stay a while with your husband.
My husband?
Yes. You are mine now.
Thank you.
will be returning soon. Withdraw, you will be recognized.
I'll arrange for you to meet Maritana at the Villa Naranja.
I must depart, but soon we meet again.
See, they have come to invite you.
Ah, sweet niece, shall we electrify them with a saraband?
Willingly.
Don Jose.
That voice. Don Cesar alive.
And kicking. You see, a good fairy removed the bullets from the arquebuses. But my executioners were such decent fellows that I could not disappoint them or disgrace them, so I fell down. They went that way, I came this way.
And for what purpose are you here?
Oh, to seek my wife.
Who told you she was here?
The same good fairy. Where is my wife?
Why, in there.
Oh, you may see her without the veil.
Oh, this creature. Hola, Marquis. Where is your wife?
The Marchioness is about to enchant our guests with some renditions upon the lute.
Can you see yourself as the Grand Master of the Aviary?
Oh, sire, I shall choke with delight.
Then instruct the Marchioness to play a part as I direct, and you may feather your nest.
But what part is the dear Marchioness to play? Is it upon the lute?
Lute? Bah! No! Come with me and I'll tell you.
Let us find her at once.
I cannot find her anywhere. Is she then but a dream? A memory?
Memory of the past. feet. And peacock, if you don't fancy Hoppa, really don't dishearten me.
Be advised by a friend. Your wife is very rich. Sign a contract for a link. And quit Madrid forever. And I guarantee you an annual subsistence of 5,000 piastres.
Step forward!
Thank you.
features?
It is the King of Spain, senor. He spoke to you yesterday.
He will be here presently. Make sure no one else enters. Look well on the features.
And if any other attempt to enter, senor?
Desire him to depart. And if he refuses, shoot him.
Senor?
Go, boy. Get your arquebus.
Si, senor.
Kings of a mortal John Cesar, what more could a
days are now, I remember well, how when you crawling man brings on. He hid his weapon, was that bell, the captain of the guard was gone. Be kind enough to make it clear, if shot has ordered t'other day, I'll be in dead. How came you here, on what I shall not do?
Your memory is short.
What forget me?
A most important, a most important thing. Chances are a date of love received. Receive the pardon, the pardon of the king.
Unhappy fate.
Thank you.
queen alone can save me. Go to the queen. To the queen. To the queen.
To the queen, then. To my king. You have sought my dishonor. You have disgraced my wife.
Sir Wei, I saved thy life.
Sire, I am here on an important mission.
From whom?
From Her Majesty the Queen.
Did they dare admit you to Her Majesty's presence?
No, sire. I climbed the wall and jumped to a kneeling position at Her Majesty's feet.
What did you want of the Queen?
To save my wife, and that effort saved my king.
Saved your king?
At least his honor, sire. As I prepared to jump, I heard a man's voice. Madame, he said, you are betrayed. The king meets his mistress in yonder villa at midnight.
The traitor!
Don Jose de Santarem.
And the queen?
And the queen.
So let me forth, I have revenge.
Too late, sire. Think you I could spare the life of the man who presumed to speak of love to thy queen? The man who would have betrayed his king? No, sire. His blood still stains this sword of mine. His villainy has died with me.
Receive your sword, Don Cesar, at the hands of your king. And may it defend your bravery as it has preserved my dignity.
Sire, sire, we have come to seek you at the request of Her Majesty.
And you find me in the presence of my most loyal servant, Don Cesar de Bazan, whom I now appoint governor of Granada.
Valencia is also vacant, sire. And Valencia is 100 leagues from Madrid, where all my creditors live.
Oh, very well. Governor of Valencia be it then.
Things are going in and out of there and are rather quick.
May I ask you to draw the winning ticket, please? Don't look.
I'm your adjudicator. Haven't we had a lovely time tonight? Yeah. In the atmosphere which I believe should always go with this show. But because the moment the curtain went up, there was lots of bustle, lots of colour, lots of involvement. And it's always good to see a chorus involved, because if you have your chorus so caught up in the action, that is, of course, transmitted to the principals, who in turn, together with the chorus, transmitted to us. I thought the grouping of the chorus was very good to begin with. It's a large chorus on a small stage, and the producer has done an excellent job in that direction. I did think the disguise of the king at the opening was a little obvious. I did feel standing in the middle of the market square with his cloak held up like that was rather likely to draw attention rather than for him to pale into nothing. And I was rather surprised when Don Jose called for a servant at one entrance, he came on from another, and that he didn't need to request wine, it just appeared. Wouldn't it be lovely if that's what happened to us? But what was excellent, you know, so often with a production, you work terribly hard putting an act together, and the final moment is lost. It never was in this production tonight. The final curtain was always a moment of real action. You know, when the curtain came down, you felt you were excluded from something that was still going on, and that is very good indeed. I was a little bothered, and I wonder if we ought to have some first aid people rushing round backstage when the king picked up that sword a few moments ago by the blade, which I'm sure must have been rather dangerous. But you see, I've been slightly pernickety with the production, and directed at the producer, which means I've had to scout around to find things which I found irritated me. So on the whole, it was very good indeed. I thought the scenery was excellent. And some very clever use of ground rows. If you don't know what ground rows are, they're those cutouts right at the back of the stage. They were very well designed, very well painted. You know, it saved having masses and masses of plots. They just stuck one of those in front of the plain sight plot at the back, and it created the perfect illusion. But the moment the curtain went up and we were in that square in Madrid, it was well painted, it was evocative of the atmosphere associated with that part of the world. One almost felt the heat. I mean, we were generating our own. There was also some coming from here. And I thought the fortress was really suitably grim, and I was quite amazed. You know, purely by scattering a bit of straw, it gave that feeling of filth and degradation. I thought it was very good. The salon had a feeling of elegance and wealth, and it was enhanced by some very good use of banners. The apartment in the final act had very good perspective and gave a great feeling of depth. The lighting I liked very much. It did create this hot, sultry atmosphere at the beginning, which meant they've got the right gels in the lights, and I think they must have been an extremely good gobo in one of the lights because it reflected the bars of the window on the floor of the stage for the opening of the second act. The props were really, on the whole, very good, and I'm a bit of a stickler for props. I really have been scouting around to notice things which were wrong. And in the end, I've only come up more or less with things I thought were very good. The only thing I found missing was a seal and ribbon on the pardon. He should have had a seal and a ribbon there. I thought the goblets were good. You know, people don't bother with goblets. They stick any old tankard in your hand. But the goblets were in period at that time. And the furniture in the last act, I'd be quite happy to take home. Even down to the quill and the brass inkstand, which was perfectly inferior. That's great credit to whoever sorted all that out. Some excellent costumes. You know, often one gets weary of peasant costumes. There are thousands of shows, all with gypsy peasants in them. But they were nicely made. They were very well blended. I liked them very much. I thought the gentry costumes, the court costumes, were completely believable in their richness. And what super! 11 out of 10 for the footwear. you know, Fed had gone a little farther. I was quite expecting it. It's very difficult, and I don't really know that you can still get them. But, you know, those court ladies, the only thing lacking in their period dress were actually fontages. And fontages were those linen pieces they wore at the back of their heads. If you've seen pictures of Queen Anne and Mary II, you'll find they always wore those linen fontages in their hair. They're very difficult to get these days, but really, this society has gone to great lengths to get other things I would have quite expected them to have had. A splendid overture, sir, with the gentle passages beautifully handled, very delicately handled. A very expressive clarinet solo, and a super lovely... side, but even so, the blending was very good. Not a lot of movement and choreography in a show of this sort. It tends to be rather static, and one accepts it as that. But the gavotte was kept very sensible, which was very simple, very sensible, fitted in, and it didn't jar on us at all. I did feel sometimes with the chorus, particularly with that Angelus chorus, which was very beautifully sung, but they did depend a great deal on their musical director. They were frightened to let go. They did, eventually, but they were afraid to do it to start with. But it's so good, and I hope you understand what I mean, to hear some lusty singing. They really let themselves go. First-class involvement in every scene, and each member of the chorus brought something to the scene that they were in. Going to the principal, to Maritana, with a strong, rich, powerful voice. What beautiful eyes she had. You know, actors and actresses forget what a great asset eyes are. And this girl, she has a lovely voice. She is lovely to look at. And she could have left it at that and we would have accepted it. But she didn't. She enhanced her performance with her beautiful eyes. It was lovely. I do wish she had to have Kirby Hairgrip holding her headdress on, which did irritate me in the first act. But a lovely leading lady, and I'm sure a worthy Maritana. Prison scene, both vocally and dramatically. There's not a great deal you can do with it. It depends on your own ability, and he did a very good job. Don Jose. Looking a very splendid cavalier. He was rather nervous to begin with because he was jumping about with his libretto, but then he quickly settled down and we got a very steady performance. I wonder if he ought to have done something about his eyes, because his brows were so heavy that his eyes actually became like slits. And it was a shame, because it detracted a little bit from his performance. We lost a very important part of him by losing his eyes. That particular part needs good eyes, and alas, he obliterated them with a rather heavy makeup. It was a good makeup, but it was too heavy. Good, firm singing voice, and he well deserved the ovation he got on at least a couple of occasions. He was slightly arrogant, I thought, ordering the king around. I thought it would have been better if he'd suggested he went on the stage than almost physically shoving him. Lazzarello, looking like an urchin, I think she was nervous too, because she developed a bit of a nervous twitch to start with. And I wondered if this was intentional, because it was distracting. And then that disappeared. And I know when you first come on stage, it is pretty terrifying. I would say to her, though, and this is true of many actors and actresses, start acting in the wings. You know, her second entrance in the first act, she hovered in the wings, at least she hovered so that we could see her. And then she came on the stage and went berserk, rushing around to everyone and giving the messages and so on. She should have come rushing on, start rushing before she actually appears. Bring the atmosphere from off the stage on. I think she found it difficult to relax in the opening solo of the second act. Not the easiest of solos. And if she wonders why I thought she was not relaxed, it was because she kept arching her left foot. Now, you may think that's rather an odd thing to notice, but I once was very fortunate in meeting Sir Alec Guinness, whom I think is one of the world's great actors. And I was lucky enough to be able to have quite a long conversation with him, and I asked him how he approached, or where he began, creating some of the wonderful characters he had created. And he said, I always start with the feet. And he said, I always think how that person will stand and how they will use their feet. And of course, it's very true. If your feet are happy in a performance, the rest of you is too. And I remember that because this foot was all twisted and arched. And then as soon as the solo was over, it went back to normal. King looking very right with his Van Dyke beard, correct in period. I didn't expect such a beautiful voice to come from that slender frame, but it did. The Marquis, a lovely study of a fop, he even got down to the beauty spot, and what a lovely, I won't do it for you tonight because these trousers are rather tight. But he did have a lovely Georgian bow, which was beautifully imperial. The Marchioness, which is a very small part, but she executed it very well, and I felt she contributed a great deal to the action. Well, this is my very first experience of Maritana, and a very happy one it's been. I was told before this performance tonight that Maritana would be special. Well, with the composer coming from Waterford, how could it be any other?